11th also. So first we'll just look at bubble sort. So for bubble sort, first we'll see the example of swapping of two variables by using a third variable. So this was one of the practical which we had done in 11. So we have taken two numbers here because the concept used in bubble sort. So just to revise what we have seen in 11. So we are taking two numbers A and B, and we are using a variable called temp to swap the two variables. Because by default, if you use only two variables, then the content of one variable, if you put it in another, that data will be destroyed. So that is why a third variable is used. Now see here, if A and B we are taking as input from the user, it is 10 and 20. So we are storing the value of A in a variable called temp. So temp will be having the value 10. Then we are storing the value of B in A. So B is 20. So B goes in A. So A becomes 20. Then finally, whatever is the value stored in temp, so temp is having 10. So that will be stored in B. So this is how the values are swapped. Like I told you in 11, so this concept of swapping, it is used in most of the programs. So this is just the basic concept that you need to know. So that is why I have just taken this example before. So all of you understood swapping of two variables by using a third variable?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So next, sir, yes.
Admit kar raha na.
Okay. So next, we are going to see the concept of arrays, because this is also used in the bubble sort algorithm. So like we have seen in the 11th standard, what do you mean by array? A array is defined as a list of data elements of the same type. And the second most important thing is that these elements are stored in consecutive memory location. So I have just shown an example. The array name is test, and in square bracket 10. 10 means the size of the array. Now this is the first element, second, third, fourth. Total 10 elements are there. Like you know that the array element starts from 0. So this is the name of the array is test. So it is having 10 values. So the first variable will be test of 0, test of 1, and so on. And the last will be test of 9. So basically, why we use arrays? Because whenever you use a normal variable, it will hold only one single value. So if you want to hold more than one value in a variable, in that case, you need to use an array. For example, marks obtained by a group of students. Okay. So I have just shown you here how the definition of array is there and the declaration. Now, defined as a list of data elements of the same type means what? Now, see here the numbers are 20, 21, 18. So they are of the same type. That means they are integer variables. Now, suppose you store 16.4. 12.8, then all the values should be of the same type, that is float. So you cannot store some integer, some float. So basically of the same type. Suppose they are characters, then all of them should be characters like A, B, C, D. So you have to define that array in the data type. Data type, array name, and the size in bracket. Okay. So we have just revised what we have seen in arrays in short. Okay. So should we proceed further?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So next, again, in the bubble sort, we are having nested for loop. So we'll just revise what a nested for loop is. So nested for loop is nothing. The placing of one loop inside the body of another loop is called nesting. So when you nest two loops, the outer loop takes control of the number of complete repetitions of the inner loop. So I have shown you the example here. When working with nested loops, the outer loop changes only after the inner loop is completely finished. So I just shown an example over here. I have not included the header files. So you can include the header files while trying at home. So this is a pattern printing program in which we are, see, this is the pattern. 1 star, 2 star, 3 star, up till 5 star. So this program it will ask you how many lines you want the pattern to be printed. So what do you mean by n? N means how many lines you want. Suppose you give 5, that means 5 lines will be printed, 1 star, 2 star, 3 star accordingly. So n means the number of lines that you want to print. Okay, so that you have to give, because some in the 11th standard they had given 100, 200, and the whole screen was covered with the stars. Okay, so you need to know what n stands for. That means how many lines you want printed on the screen. Now see, I have written it in red color, outer loop and inner loop. So nested means what? Placing of one list within another list. So it can be nested if, nested for, or any other. Okay. Now see, this is the outer loop and this is the inner loop. Two for loops are there, one inside the another. See, I have written here, the outer loop changes only after the inner loop is completely finished. So that means what? Until this condition is finished, it is satisfied, then it will go to the above loop. Now see how these two loops will work. See, I have shown the diagram over here in which the values are put. Now see here, for I is equal to 0, below also j is equal to 0. And suppose we have inputted the n as 5. Okay. Now see, I is 0, j is 0. And the condition is what? J is less than equal to I. Okay. Then we have to just see out star. Now see, first I is 0, then it will go in the inner loop. First the outer loop will be starting. I is equal to 0, I is less than n. Now n is what? N is 5. I plus plus, when this will happen? When the complete thing is over, then I will be incremented by 1. So initially I is 0, I is less than n. N we have entered it as 5. So the condition is true. So it will go into inner loop. So again, here the condition is j is equal to 0, j is less than equal to I. Now what is I? Initially I was 0. So again the condition is true. It will go below and it will just print out 1 star. See, I have shown it here. Initially I is 0, j is 0, 1 star will be printed. Then after that star, what will happen to the value of j? It will increment by 1. So j will become 1. Now initially I is 0. So we are again checking the condition. J is less than equal to I. So this condition becomes false and it will exit out of this loop and go to the above loop. See, initially I is 0, j is 0, then j will increment by 1. When j will become 1, this condition will become false, because I is 0, j less than equal to 0, condition is false. So when j will become 1, it will exit and it will go to the outer loop, which is this, for I is equal to 0. Then what will happen? I will increment by 1. Now I will be 1. Again it will check the condition, I is less than n. So n is 5. So condition is true. Again it will go to the inner loop. Again the inner loop will start from 0. First j is 0. Then what will happen? It will just print a star. 1 star it will print. Then what will happen? J will increment by 1. Okay. So when j will increment by 1, again the condition is true, because I is 1, j is less than equal to I, means condition is true. Again one more star will be printed. Then what will happen? J will become 2. So when j will become 2, j is less than equal to I is 1. So condition becomes false. When it becomes 2, it will exit, again go to the outer loop. Now I will increment by 1, so that will be 2. Again j, starting from 0, 1 star will be printed. Then j will become 1, one more star is printed. J will become 2, one more star is printed. When j becomes 3, it will exit. So when j will become 3, it will exit. So 3 stars are printed. Again I will become increment by 1. So when I will increment by 1, again it will go to the inner loop. Again starting from 0, 0, 1 star will be printed. Then j will become 1. again one more star, j will increment by 1, j will become 2, one more star, increment by 1, one more star. Finally, when j will become 4, it will exit. Now the value of I will be incremented by 1. Again, the same sequence like I told you before. When it becomes 5, it will exit. It will go to the outer loop. Again, I equal to 5. The condition is false because initially the value of n was 5. So I less than n. So I is 5, less than 5. Again, the condition will, it will exit. So both the loops, it will exit and it will just get out of this loop. So this pattern will be printed 1 star, 2 star, 3 star, 4 star and 5 star. So all of you understood nested for loop?
Yes, sir.
Because this concept we are going to use in the bubble sort algorithm. Now this process we are just going to see how it works. So whatever you are seeing on the screen, whenever an algorithm is asked, this you should not write. This is just for your explanation. So whenever I tell you that this you have to write, then you have to write it in the exam. Okay. Now see the bubble sort process. Now consider an array in which the first element is a1, a2, a3 and so on up till an. Okay, and this is the second last element, that is why an minus 1. So suppose the list of numbers a1, a2 up till an is in memory. How the bubble sort works? Now we have seen it in 11 that we have to compare the first element with the second element, and whichever is the larger, that we have to interchange. If the first element is smaller than the next element, it will remain the same. Now see, these are the elements in array a1, a2, a3 up till a9. Now what we are going to do, first compare a1 and a2 and arrange them in desired order so that a1 is less than a2. That means the first number is smaller than the second number. What will happen if the first number is greater than the second number? Then compare a2 and a3 and arrange them so that a2 is less than a3. Continue until we compare an minus 1 with an, that is the second last element with the last element. If a1 is greater than a2, then we have to interchange. A2 will come here, a1 will come here. Then again compare the second element with the third element. If it is greater, interchange. If it is smaller, keep it same. Now see, the largest element is bubbled to the nth position. Nth means the last position. Step 1 involves n minus 1 comparison. When step 1 is completed, an will contain the largest element. So suppose the elements are there in the array and you are comparing the first element with the second, whichever is the largest, you are just interchanging. So like this, you are going through the array till the last element. Second last element with the last element you are going to compare. So that is why it will require one element less. Suppose n is the number of size of the array. So while comparing, you will require n minus 1 comparisons. So every time what will happen? The largest element in the array, it will go to the last position. So that is why this process is called as bubble sort. Just like in the water, the bubbles come in the top. Same way here, whichever is the largest element, it will go to the last while comparing the first pass. Okay. Now the second step, repeat steps with one less comparison. One less comparison means what? Now see, suppose these are the elements in the array a1, a2, a3, an minus 1 and an. What will happen after you compare the, you are going to the process, compare the first element with the second, interchange, second element with the third, interchange. So what will happen? An will contain the largest element in the array. So when we are doing the step 2 with one less comparison, see, I have written it in blue color. Why? Because we already know that the last element is the largest element, A of n. So no need to compare this element again. So we are only going to compare a1 to an minus 1. We are not going to compare the last element. Why? Because we know that it is the largest element and no need to compare it again. So again, we are going to compare with one less comparison. When step 2 is completed, second largest element will occupy an minus 1. So again, you do the same step again. Then the second largest element will contain the largest element among these a1 to an minus 1. So what will happen upon after second step? The last element will be the largest element. Previous to that, it will have the second largest element. So like this, you are going to do n minus n steps. See, total number of elements are n. So how many times you are going to do this process? N minus 1 times, till the array is sorted in ascending order. So this is just for your explanation. In the exam, if it is asked, then you have to write the algorithm. The algorithm I'll show you later. So first I am going to show you how this process works. Sometimes in the exam, what will happen? You will be given some elements. All of you can see the bubble sort?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now see, sometimes in the exam, the question will be asked, write down the bubble sort algorithm and show how it works. So how you have to show? Sometimes the elements will be given like this, array of 5 elements. Sometimes the elements will be given like this, 52, 41, 4, 8, 5. Any random numbers will be given to you. Then you have to show it stepwise. Sometimes if the question is for 4 marks, then the solving is of 1.5 mark and 2.5 mark is for the algorithm. Or it may be 2-1 or 2-2 also, depending upon the marks. Either it is for 3 marks or 4 marks. And same way, bubble sort for the practical exam, it is for 50 marks. So only one program may be asked. Suppose you have got bubble sort, then you have to just write the program for bubble sort. And if your journal is complete, and if you give proper oral answers, then you can get 50 out of 50 in paper 1. Now see, I have just taken an example of 5 elements. So these 5 elements are there in the array. Now see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I have given the size of A4. Why I have written A4 and not A5? Because array element starts from 0 and not 1. So 52 will be A0, 41 will be A1, A2, A3 and A4. So like this, you have to show it in the exam. First, you have to write number 1 and write down the array as it is, 51, 41, 4, 8 and 5 in a sequence. Then what you can do, you can just round the first two numbers. 52 you can just circle, 41 you can just circle. I have not shown it here, but in the exam you can just circle this. That means it will mean that you are comparing the first two elements. Now 52 is greater than 41. Yes. So what will happen? It will interchange. 41 will come here, 52 will come here. You can just show it here. So the two numbers are interchanged. Okay. So see, 41, 52. And I have written the rest of the elements as it is. Okay. Now next step is what? Second element with the third element. So we are comparing 52 with 4. Again, 52 is greater than 4. Yes. So interchange. 4 will come here, 52 will come here. 4, 52. So the next line is 41, 4, 52, 8, 5. So again, we are going to compare the third element with the fourth. So again, 52 is greater than 8. Yes. So interchange. So 8 will come here, 52 will come here. Then again, we are going to compare the second last element with the last element. 52 greater than 5. Yes. So interchange. So 5. So this is pass 1. Pass 1 means what? You are doing step 1. So after the step 1, so you will get this array, 41, 4, 8, 5, 52. See, purposefully I have written 52 in red color. Why? Because after the processing of the first step, the largest element will go to the last, or it will be bubbled to the last. So every time you do one processing of the entire array, then the largest element will go to the last. So this is the new list, 41, 4, 8, 5, 52. We have seen in the algorithm, after you do one pass, then what we have to do? The last element we have to ignore, and up till n minus one elements, you have to take the new list. So here 52 is there. So what now I have written here, end of pass one. What is a pass? The process of sequentially traversing. Traversing means moving through all or part of a list is called a pass. So here the array is there. So we are moving from 52 till 5, and whichever is the largest element, it goes to the last. So this is one pass. So you have to take the list again and do the processing again from start, end of pass one. I have just written this line again here. Now see the second pass. Again, you have to compare the first element with the second. 41 is greater than 4. Yes. So interchange. Then this two will be interchanged, 4, 41. Rest of the list will be same. Then again, compare the second element with the third element. 41 is greater than 8. Yes. So interchange. So again, we have interchange here, 4, 8, 41, 5, 52. Then again, next we have to compare 41 with 5. If it is greater, interchange. Now see, I have written the list again here, 4, 8, 5, 41, 52. So after the end of pass 2, n minus n element will become the largest. So first largest, second largest. Okay, so when you are comparing the next list, again these two will be ignored, and you will be comparing only the three numbers. Now see here, from the first step, how many steps were there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you see in the second, 1, 2, 3, 4, one step less. Okay. Similarly, if you see in the next step, one more step is reduced. So like this, every time one step will be reduced, because every time you are getting the largest element, first largest, second largest, third largest. And sometimes even it may happen that after you do the second pass, the elements may be in the sorted order. So no need to again do the processing. So all of you are understanding this? Because in the exam, you have to write it like this only.
Yes, sir.
Now see, after the second pass, we are getting this list. 4, 8, 5, 41, 52. I have just written this list here. Then the same list again, we have to write here. Again, from starting, compare the first element with the second. Now 4 is greater than 8? No. Okay. The first element is not greater than the second. So write the list as it is, 4 and 8. See, I have written it 4 and 8 like this. Then again compare the second element with the third. 8 is greater than 5? Yes. So interchange 5 and 8. So we have interchanged 5 and 8. And the last two numbers, they are already sorted, because we know that the last element is the largest element, second last element. So see here, we are getting the third last element. So like this, after each pass, the largest element will be bubbled to the last or second last or the third last. Now see, we can see here that the data is sorted. Now if it was not sorted, then one more step you have to write with one less comparison. See here, 5 comparisons are there, 4, 3. So every time one comparison less. So all of you understood how to write the in the exam?
Yes, sir.
Now this is the algorithm that we have to write in the exam. So don't make any changes to the algorithm, or don't write on your own. Whatever I have shown you on the screen, just dicto write it on the board paper, because this is the algorithm which is there in the textbook also and on the reference book also. So you have to just write it as it is, then only you can get full marks. So usually the algorithm is asked along with the steps. So any steps you can take and you can write the algorithm. Now I'll just explain the algorithm over here, bubble sort algorithm. This you have to write. See the one over here, this is just the process. This is for you to understand. So don't write this in exam, because many people around 2 years back, they had written this process. So they got only half an mark, because when you are asked algorithm, then this is what you have to write. So last year also I had told you that you have to write from start, bubble data, comma n, then what this data means, what n means. So most of you in the journal also, you are directly started with the first step. So if you do this in the board exam, then you may lose half a mark for not writing the name, the what is data, what is n. Okay, so start from bubble. Bubble, actually this is the name of the function. So function also we are going to take later. So these are the parameters passed to that function. So data is the name of the array, and n is the number of elements which are there in the array. Data comma n. So you have to start from this. If the question is asked in the exam, write down bubble sort algorithm. So you have to start from bubble bracket data comma n. You have to write what data stands for. So data is an array with n elements. It can be 5, 10, anything. So n is a variable. So this algorithm sorts the element in the data. So this is an array which we are going to sort. Now see the steps. Repeat step second and third for k is equal to n to n minus 1. While like we had seen in the previous example, if there are 5 elements in the array, so one less comparison we are going to do. So I have written here k is some variable. Okay, in the program it can be anything, I, j, whatever you write, but I have just written it for some purpose. K is equal to n to n minus 1. 1 means what? It is the first element, and n minus 1 means the second last element. So we have to repeat second and third steps from starting element to the n minus 1 element. Okay, now see, like we initialize any variable, like say I is equal to 1 or I is equal to 0. So I have just initialized one variable called ptr to 1. Okay, for going through that array. See, like printing an array, we start with the 0th element and we print the last element. So step by step we increment the value of I by 1. So similarly, pointer is means nothing, it is not a pointer, it is just a name of the variable ptr. Okay, it can be anything. So that is initialized to 1. Now what is the third step? Repeat while pointer is less than equal to n minus k. Now n is what? N means the number of elements in the array. And what is k? Why I have written this n minus k, I will explain you in the while showing you the program. So while this number 1, it is less than equal to n minus k, keep on doing this. So this is for the comparison of the data. Okay, while this loop is used. So after I show you the program, it will become clear to you. Now see, data is what? The name of the array. It can be anything, a, b, c, d, and this is the pointer. Pointer now is what? The first variable is 1. Actually, we are writing this algorithm. That is why I started from 1. But while writing the program, you have to start from 0. Okay, because the array elements start from 0 and not 1. Now what is this? If data ptr is greater than data ptr plus 1, ptr is nothing but the variable. So actually, if data 0 is greater than the first element, that means the first element is greater than the second element, then interchange data ptr and data ptr plus 1. That means we are just going to swap the two numbers. Then we are going to increment the pointer. That means after we increment the pointer, what will happen? We are going to the next element. Now next will be what? We are comparing the second element with the third element. Again, it will increment by 1. So like this, we are going to the complete array. End of inner loop, end of step 1, outer loop. So after this is done, one pass will be done, and that array, this will be done. End of pass 1. Then after this, again, we'll go to the pass 2. Now the time complexity. Usually this question is asked in the fill in the blanks. What is the time complexity of bubble sort algorithm? So I have written in red color, worst case, order of n square. Okay. Now this is the best case. So usually best case rarely occurs. Now best case is what? That the array is usually sorted, and you have to apply this bubble sort on them. So usually that doesn't occur, that the array is sorted and you are going to sort the data. Okay, so whenever the question is asked, then you have to write order of n square in the fill in the blanks. Usually this question is asked many times. What is the time complexity? Now, time complexity means what? Now, suppose there are two different algorithms for sorting. Now, if we have got just the bubble sort, but there are many, like insertion sort, heap sort, and many a sorting are there. So time complexity means which algorithm is the fastest. Okay, so that comparison is there. Suppose bubble sort works in say 5 minutes, and another quick sort works in say 3 minutes, and any other heap sort is there, suppose it works in 1 minute. So which is the best sorting technique? So for that the time complexity is used. So you just remember, if it is asked in the exam for fill in the blanks, what is the time complexity of bubble sort algorithm, you have to just write n square. Don't write the best quest, that is why I purposefully written in red color, order of n square. Okay, best case is usually it never occurs. When this will happen? When the elements are already sorted, then this will happen. Okay, so all of you understood the bubble sort algorithm?
Yes sir.
So next we are going to see the program. See, purposefully I have written both the algorithm and the program side by side, so that it will be easy for you to see that how it works. Okay, now see the bubble sort we have already seen previously, and the program I have written here. See, the earlier part, the header files and the declaration of the variables I have just taken. See here the last line, all of you see out, enter the number of elements. Okay, now see, most of you while doing this program in the practicals, you didn't know what to enter here. Most of you thought that these are the elements that you have to enter one by one, but actually now see here, the size of the variable is 10. That means we have got an array of size 10. Now you have to decide that how many elements you want to enter in that array. You can enter one element also, two element, three element, up till 10, not greater than 10, because array size is 10. You cannot enter more than 10 elements. So first thing is what? Enter the number of elements. Now suppose the array size you have declared, it is 10. Now if you want to enter say 5 elements, okay? So here it is asking that you want to enter 5 elements. So after that, in the for loop, one by one, you will enter the 5 elements, okay? Most of you, what you did, you are entering numbers in sequence 1, 2, 3. So after you enter the elements, suppose someone types 1, that means it will ask you only one element. So if there is only one element, then there is no use of sorting, okay? So this is n means how many numbers you want to enter as an array. So if you write 5, that means it will take 5. Now this for loop, it is for that sir. Purpose. Yes
sir, the array is 10 dile, so the 10 cha jagi apan n lihu shakto ka?
No, you cannot write n, that will be an error, because random elements cannot be taken in an array. For that you have to use the concept of pointers, and in that dynamically you can allocate memory to the array. Whenever you want, you can insert an element. Whenever you want, you can delete an element. So that is used in the pointers. Here you cannot declare n, a of n, that will be an error. So you have to give some specific size. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now the for loop, I is equal to 0, I is less than n. Now suppose you have written 5, that means this will take 5 elements, 10, 20, 30, 40. You can write it in any random manner. Okay, so 5 elements will be taken here. Now see, this two for loops I have written here, nested for loop. Now this is the outer for loop and this is the inner for loop. Now I have written here purposefully show you some why it is written like this. Now I told you I is equal to 0, I is less than n minus 1. Why n minus 1? Suppose the array elements are 5. Okay, so when array elements are, suppose the size of the array is 5, because array element starts from 0, so obviously n, suppose n you are writing 5, so if it starts from 0, obviously 0 1 2 3 4, okay, so that will be 5. So that is why you have to write here n minus 1, because n is the number of elements. Array element starts from 0, so 0 is added to that, so one number less. So suppose n is 5, so here it will be I less than 4. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is 5 elements. All of you understood this?
Yes, sir.
Now, in the next for loop, j is equal to 0, j is less than n minus 1 minus I have written. Even if you write n minus 1, if you don't write minus I, this program will work. Okay. But what will happen if you don't write minus I? Why I have written this minus I will tell you. If you write this for loop same way and j is less than n minus 1, don't write this minus I. This program will work correctly for any given of numbers. But why minus I have written? Because see, I have shown you the steps. Each time what happens? See, the first time 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 number of times we have moved through the array. In the next time, we have got the largest element. Then here second largest element. So every time one step will be less. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here it was 5 steps, 4 steps, 3 steps, and so on. It will reduce by 1 each time. Okay. So minus I, why I have written it like this. See, this is the outer loop. This is the inner loop. Once the inner loop gets finished, it will go to the outer loop. Outer loop will increment by 1. Again, it will come below. It will do the processing. Once the condition is false, again, it will go to the outer loop. Like this, outer, inner. It will keep on moving. Okay. So initially, I is 0. Here, j is 0. Less than n minus 1 minus I. Now, what is I? Initially, I is 0. So it will be the same. Suppose 5 number of elements are there. I is less than 5. J is less than 5. N minus 1 is there. So sorry, it will be I is less than 4. Here also J will be less than 4. So what we are doing? We are comparing the first element with the second element. AJ is greater than. So if it is greater, then see the swapping program that we have seen in the first, that how to swap two elements by using a third variable. So here we are using that concept in the array. So temp is a variable in which we are storing the first value, and we are just keeping second value we are keeping in the first, and whatever is stored first value, that again we are giving to the second element. So it will be interchange. Okay. Then again I will be 1. When I will be 1, again it will come below. Again it will start processing from 0. But what will happen here? Now I has become 1. So n minus 1 minus I. So here what it will become? Suppose number of elements n is 4, 5. So 5 minus 1 is 1. I has become 1 here. It has come below. So what will happen to j? J less than 3 it will become. Because the value of here I equal to 1. So 1 less for the second pass. So one element less we are going to take. Again, we are going to do the comparison. Then again, I will become 2. Then again, here I value will be taken 2. One more comparison will be taken. So this is how the program will work. So I'll just show you how this works. Then it will become clearer to you, this condition. See, all of you see, this is the array that we have taken. All of you can see this array. 52, 41, 4, 8, 5.
Yes, sir.
Now see, the program that we have seen before, I have just written the for loop. Okay. Rest of the program I have not written. This for loop only I have taken, and with respect to the program. So we have already taken the array. So these are the array elements that we have taken. 52, 41, 4, 8, and 5. So these are the random elements that we have taken. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is A of 4. N is 5 because the number of elements we want, we are given 5. 5 elements are there, starting from 0 till the 4th element. Now see this how program will work. I is equal to 0, j is equal to 0. See, I have written it here. I is equal to 0, j is equal to 0. And the condition is what? J is less than n minus 1 minus I. Condition also I have written it over here. And I am comparing the first element with the second element. And if they are interchange, I am just writing it over here. Okay. Now see, this is the array. Initially, I is 0, j is 0. See, I is 0, j is 0. So we are comparing aj. Aj means what? A of 0th element with j plus 1. That means the first element with the second element. So whether 52 is greater than 41? Yes. So we are just interchanging them, 41, 52. Then what will happen? Value of j will increment by 1. I is 0. It will remain 0 only. So till this loop is executed, then j will become 1. So what will happen? J1, that means the second element. Now here, 41 has gone here, 52 has come here. Okay. So 52 greater than 4. See, j has become 1. Okay. So we are again comparing 52 with 4. Because 41 has gone here, 52 has come here. We are comparing this element with this. So again, this is the larger. So we are just interchanging them, 4 and 52. Then again, value of j will increment by 1. It will become 2. Now these values are interchanged. 4 has come here, 41 has, 52 has come here. And we are comparing 52 with 4. So 4 will come here and 52 will go here. So again, we are comparing 52 with 8. First element is greater than the second. So interchange. So again, j will become 3. It will increment by 1. Then what we are happening, comparing? We are comparing 5. So which element is greater that we are interchanging? So j will become 4. And the condition is what here? J less than 4. So it will exit and go to the outer loop. So after step 1 or pass 1, so these are the values, sorted values, 41, 4, 8, 5, and 52. So purposefully, the last element I have shown in red color, because the end of pass 1, the largest element will go to the last. And when we are sorting it again in the pass 2, no need to take the last element. Only the first four elements you have to take. So that is why the meaning of this n minus 1 minus I. Now what will happen? Now I will become 1. Okay. See, after this 4, it is exiting from this loop. It is going to the outer loop. Now initially I was 0. Now it has become 1. Okay. Then again it will go to the inside loop, inner loop, starting again from 0. 0. Now because I has become 1 here, now j, it was earlierly 4, because n means what? 5. So here what it will be? 5 minus 1 minus I. See, this 1, it is subtracting from here. Why this 1? Because we have already got the last element. We don't need to compare this again. So that is why we are incrementing I by 1. So j is less than 3. Now see here the comparisons, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 comparisons are there. So here only 3 comparisons are there. And similarly here 2. So each time one comparison less. So that is why minus I have written. So all of you understood the meaning of minus I? Why I have written this like this? Yes? Minus I, why I have written? All of you understood? Yes or no? See, again, we'll see the second step. After the first step, you are getting this array. Okay. Last element is the largest. Now I is 1. See how this for loop works. Now these are two for loops. First for loop, second for loop. Initially, I will be 0. It will go to the inside loop. And when this condition becomes false, it will go again to the outer loop. And this will increment by 1. Then again, it will check the condition, go inside loop. Again, when this loop is finished, again it will go to the outer loop. This will increment by 1 once more. Now like this has incremented by 1. Again you go to the inner loop, j less than 3. Now this was the earlier array. Now this has become like this. So whether the first element is greater than the second, 41 is greater than 4, yes. So interchange, 4 will go here, 41 will come here. Okay. Now see this, 4 and 41. Now next j will become 1. Then what will happen? 41 has gone here. So again 41 with 8 comparison. So this is larger. So again interchange. So the third time j will be 2. Again 41 is greater than 5. Interchange. Now when j will become 3, the condition will become false and it will go to the outer loop and I will become 2. Now see the next array, 41, 52. Second largest element is bubble to the second last. So we have got two largest, second largest. Now we need to compare only the three elements, not the entire array. So now I is 2, again it will go to the inner loop, j is 0, j is less than n minus 1 minus I, see this comparison. So now j will become 2. See, earlier it was 4, n means the number of elements, minus I means we are just making one less, I was 0. So here j was 4, here it has become 3, here it has become 2. Because we have to compare only these two elements. See, here we have to compare three elements. Here we have to compare four elements. So that is why the number of steps every time it is going to decrement by one. So that is the use of this I. When this increments, this will decrement. So every time this will increment by one, we are reducing this by one more time. Okay. So all of you understood this minus I, why I have written like this? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
See, if you don't understand, then you can just, I'll post this again on the YouTube. Then you can just see how it works. Unless and until you write this some numbers, random numbers, and see how it works, then it will become clear to you. See, you have to just write it down three or four times and solve it in proper steps. Then it will become clear to you. See, this thing you are not to show in the exam, okay? See, in the practical, what will happen? Only this program you have to write. Hash include iostream up till get ch. If you write this program, if your journal is complete, and if you give proper exam, oral exam, you can get 50 out of 50 if this question is asked. No need to write the algorithm also. But in the exam, theory paper, this algorithm will be asked along with these steps, okay? See, these steps you have to write. No need to draw the diagram also. You can directly start from the one. Just write the name of the array. 1, 2, 3. Finish. And this algorithm. And this is just, I have written for explanation. No need to draw this in the exam or anywhere else. This is just for your explanation that how the nested for loop works. All of you understood? If you don't understand, you can just ask me. Or you can again refer it back in the YouTube. Okay. Now see how the complexity of this algorithm is done. Why O n square? You don't have to write this in the exam. Just remember order of n square. N minus 1, n minus 2 up till last element. So this is how the formula has been calculated. N square. So usually this type of questions are asked in the fill in the blanks. What is the time complexity of bubble sort algorithm? So you have to just write, if n square is just asked in the options, just write n square. If order of n square is written given, you have to just write it like this. Don't write the best case. Best case is this, O of n. Usually it doesn't happen. So you have to write the worst case. Okay. So all of you understood the bubble sort algorithm?